Sakafets YouTube, and welcome back to my channel. Let us make the most delicious tomato soup. Hello my darling, so I'm back with a new recipe, and this one is for some tomato soup. I'm gonna be using about 6 medium tomatoes, and I'm gonna chop them up roughly and place them into a bowl. Once my tomatoes are nicely chopped up, it's time to get down to the soup. Using my gorgeous pot, I'm gonna add in some oil, and I'm gonna saute some onions and garlic for about 2 to 3 minutes until fragrant. After about 2 minutes, I'm gonna go ahead and add in my tomatoes. Just let it sweat for about 2 to 3 minutes before we go in with our seasonings and all these other good stuff. I've also just added in some tomato paste because I really like my soup to be rich and dark red. So it's optional. You don't have to do it if you don't want to. And once my seasonings and everything are in, I'm just gonna go ahead and just cover this up and just let it cook down on low heat for about 20 minutes. So after 20 minutes, this is how it was looking, guys. As you can see, the tomatoes have rendered down quite a bit. I am gonna taste and adjust it accordingly, but when I did, it didn't need anything, so I'm just gonna mix it up quickly before going in with a few other seasonings. Because this tomato soup is nearly cooked, I'm gonna go ahead and add in some double cream. You can use heavy cream or whichever cream you prefer. I'm also gonna add in some basil. How do you say it? Is it basil or basil? Let me know how you say it. I'm gonna go ahead and add that in. Mix it in well, add my cream of course, and just let it simmer for about 5 more minutes. After about 5 minutes, this is how my soup was looking, guys. This was ready to serve. However, I don't like my soup to be chunky, so I'm gonna empty the pot and just pop it into my blender, and we're gonna go ahead and blend it up. There you have it, my loves, all done. Do you see how creamy this looks? And you know the perfect tomato soup pairs really well with a grilled cheese sandwich. So I'm just going to make one really quickly in my cast iron pan before I go ahead and serve this up. Once the grilled cheese sandwich was cooked, it was time to serve. Guys, do you see how creamy this looks? So, so delicious. This makes for a perfect hearty meal, especially as the autumn weather is coming up. And yes, my loves, you can also serve it as an appetizer, whatever you prefer. I'm gonna top it off with a little bit of heavy cream just to make it nice and presentable, as well as a few leaves of basil. We're gonna just dunk in that beautiful grilled cheese sandwich on the side. You can always top it off with some Parmesan cheese like I did, but yes, look at that cheese pool. So, so gorgeous. I really hope you enjoyed the recipe. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. I really appreciate you guys. Oh my goodness, look at that. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.